And yet, why did Priam not return Helen to Menelaus, her husband? So much suffering, so many lives would have been spared. Nothing simple is ever easy. Fear and doubt fester secretly in the hearts of men, condemning their lives into the darkness of guilt. So was Priam guilty of a sin which he hid from all who knew him until his shameful act reared its dark head and came back to face him and demand retribution. It happened years before the war, when the gods looked favorably upon Troy and showered it with peace and plenty. That year, the altars were kept burning with offerings to the gods. King Priam sought the best bull in the land and offered it as a prize in a tournament. It was a great day. The first day of the end.
Amazing! People of Troy! Alexandros the Shepherd! Quite a beauty, isn't he?
It's my bull, stolen from my herd.
It's a prize offered by King Priam for the games. Are you saying the king stole it?
His servants did, to keep the gold they were to buy it with. It's my bull!
Well, if you want to get it back, you've got quite a challenge on your hands. That is Deiphobus, Prince of Troy. I hear he's the finest swordsman of Priam's many sons. And Hector, the eldest prince.
Sparring against common men was an easy task, but facing Deiphobus was too much of a risk for Alexandros. Instead of competing for the bull against Troy's champions, the young shepherd untied the ropes holding the beast and pulled it out of the arena. Deiphobus would not stand for this insult and went after the young man. Alexandros fled through the streets of Troy to the altar of Zeus, where he hoped to find sanctuary.
What? The lost son of Priam has returned.
Don't speak to me of my lost son. Your delusions have brought me enough pain already, Cassandra.
He is your son.
Young man, who is your father?
My father was Agelaus, a shepherd, as am I.
Agelaus? He was a valued servant in my court. The man I trusted to take my Paris.
You are the torch which brings fire and death to Troy.
Great king! King Priam!
Father!
Forgive me, O great king. Have mercy. I could not bring myself to do what you asked of me. Have mercy on him. It is I who should be punished for disobeying you, sire.
Never has disobedience been so welcome. It's true. The day you were born, Isakos, the sacred seer, foretold that you would be the ruin of Troy. His words were never false. So I ordered Agelaus to take the child from his crib and end his life. From this moment on, you are a true prince of Troy, my Paris. And none shall ever threaten you again.
So, as Paris returned to Priam's household, the shepherd prince became known throughout the Troas and was envied for his beauty and strength. It was Aphrodite, goddess of love, who years later drove Paris to Sparta and into Helen's arms, kindling a love that ignited a fire that consumed the world. How could Priam refuse anything his son asked of him? It was with a heavy heart that he welcomed Helen when Paris brought her to Troy. Guilt so easily forces men to act against their own interests. The people of Troy took pause to think, to doubt, to wait. They knew it was only a matter of time, that there was a price to pay for a father's love, a father's guilt towards his forgotten son. They did not wait for long. Helen watched the battle waged in her name and felt the rage against her, same as a dying beast sees vultures circling above it, waiting for their time to feast on its carcass. Likewise did Paris endure the scorn from Greek and Trojan alike. He was not only the cause of all their misery, but also the only hope for their deliverance. This was, after all, his fight, his cause, his battle to win or lose.
Helen, do not blame yourself for Troy's misery. I am the one who caused it, and I am the one who must end it. No, I can't leave now. I have to do this.
Dephobos!
Paris? I cannot believe my eyes! There are no altars to hide behind out here! Why are you here, Paris? Has Helen driven you from her bed? I may deserve your censure, Dephobos, but it is time I face the consequences of what I have done.
You speak like a true prince, brother. Our men need our help. Lead the way. Let's restore their faith in us and in your honor.
You've wished me dead for years, Dephobos.
Paris, I only wish for this war to end.
And it shall, one way or another.
Not that way, Paris!
Thank you. Over here! Help us, please!
Success bodes well, brother. Let's hurry to aid the rest of our men. With you, Paris!
You warned me against going to Sparta. You knew.
Cassandra dreamed that you would bring only death upon your return.
No one ever believes Cassandra.
Claim your honor like the desert craves water, brother. But come, there are more of our men in peril.
Had I listened to you, none of this would have happened.
You cannot change the will of the gods. You are riding on the wings of victory!
Not yet enough. I need to face the man I've wronged.
You want to issue a challenge? Are you sure, brother?
It's the only way. For better or for worse, the war ends today.
Paris, may the gods be with you.
I wish you well, brother.
Menelaus!
The last time I saw you, I greeted you as a friend. Today, I meet you as my enemy.
Today, one of us shall fall for the love of Helen. If it is to be you, will you promise that the kings of Greece leave Troy forever?
And if you are the one to grace the gates of Hydas tonight, will Helen be returned to me?
Those are the terms.
So be it!
Today, Menelaus.
Do not have any doubt, Shepherd Prince. Charon is waiting for you.
You have fought for many long years for my honor. Now at last, I will end the war which I started. Aphrodite came to my aid, took me away from the battle. I am saved.
You are. I wonder how many will rejoice.
Is this the honor a Trojan prince shows in a challenge of his own issue? Is this what Helen left me for?
We cannot abandon him. He's our father's son.
It's useless. The gods have already determined our fate.